Each little package, $30. Damn. It's crazy. I'm in the wrong business, huh?
On the northwest corner of Larkin and Turk in San Francisco, you'll find a group of people standing around. I call them the Backpack Brigade. They used to hang out on Dodge Alley, but that now has been cleaned up, so I guess you can say they were literally run out of Dodge. You might find incense burning to keep the alley smelling fresh. Now, on any given day, you will find this crowd often hunkered behind a black construction tarp for privacy, some selling and some using drugs. It could be anything from crack cocaine, methamphetamines, heroin, or fentanyl.
So this is San Francisco, and some people call it Gotham by the Bay. And you know, Gotham is from Batman, where back in the day, everything was lawlessness. So it's ironic that they're selling fentanyl and crack cocaine 25 feet away from the Philip Burton Federal Building in San Francisco.
Now, you could place the blame solely on the federal government, or you can throw the blame entirely on the San Francisco Police Department. However, I'd like to spread some of the blame around because some residents actually prefer the drug dealers over the drug users. This man, who has a stay-away order from the entire Tenderloin District, was spotted on the 600 block of Eddy Street by SFPD bike cops, and he was arrested. In his possession, what appears to be crack cocaine. He also, according to police officials, has opened cases that have not been prosecuted. Now, you might think the residents would be happy to see a suspected drug dealer arrested, but listen to this.
I mean, because really, the dealers, they're just kids. I feel bad for them. They're doing what they have to do to stay alive. They're just kids, and they're not dangerous. It's the junkies and the addicts and the homeless that are dangerous, not the dealers.
The resident also believes the minors are basically being groomed to take over the job of selling drugs.
Have you noticed any kind of some of the people you picked up with drugs as being minors, being groomed to sell out here? Or are they mostly adults?
It isn't uncommon for the officers to arrest minors that are selling drugs. I don't know anything about any grooming, and I will say that the vast majority of the arrests that I'm aware of are adults.
Captain Chris Canning started his police career at the Tenderloin District, and now he heads it. The bulk of the open-air drug sales happen in his district.
I do understand that there is a significant number of narcotics enforcement activity. The majority, as I understand it, does happen in the Tenderloin.
Which brings me back to the Backpack Brigade. There's a constant exchange of money for drugs, which sometimes gets broken up when a San Francisco police cruiser rolls by, or when a federal police officer rolls up and pushes them away. But just like the ebb and flow of an ocean wave, they soon return. For example, seconds after a San Francisco police cruiser rolls by, I witness money and what appears to be drugs exchanging hands. One of the women grabs a black plastic bag and pulls out a clear bag with a white substance and hands it to the woman, who then walks away. But it's not just this corner. On the other side of the Tenderloin District, in an area known as United Nations Plaza, where more backpack-carrying men and women can usually be spotted heading down the escalator when the police are spotted. Ironically, many of them take BART to travel back and forth with the drugs. This is about a half a pound of fentanyl seized from one backpack, along with heroin and crack cocaine by local law enforcement.
But think about that. Think about that for a minute. People are on BART commuting to their day job, which is being on the corner selling drugs, with a backpack full of one of the most lethal drugs known to man that could kill everyone if somebody decided, hey, yeah, I'm gonna jack this dude for it. Because this is not robbing a marijuana dispensary, going in, you're just gonna steal plants. This is actually physically taking a bag of potent drugs with the possibility of it being released on a train full of innocent people, because it's always the innocent people getting caught up in this.
Bay Area Rapid Transit, also known as BART, sent me a detailed statement saying, in part, BART has well-established procedures to handle a wide range of incidents aboard train cars, including the dissemination of unknown powders and potentially dangerous substances. Some people say if you eliminate the demand, you eliminate the need for sellers. Now you're just trying to insert logic. Let me say this. There's absolutely nothing logical about what's going on here, like the phrase, help reduction. Oh yeah, that's next. That being said, it's important to note the federal government just announced they broke up what they called the East Bay Pipeline. People transporting drugs from the East Bay to San Francisco using BART and rideshare vehicles. But for how long? In the Tenderloin District, Stanley Roberts for Gotham by the Bay.